Dr. T, and we're stepping into Dr. T's wheelhouse right now, and we're talking about, there's an urgent alert tonight about antibiotics. So doctors say that they're not working as well as they used to, which is scary point one. And without new options soon, researchers now estimate that nearly, and this number, it could be staggering, it's worldwide, but still staggering, 40 million people could die from infections by the year 2050. Here to explain is Dr. Todd Ellerin, Chief of Infectious Diseases at South Shore Health. Wow. I mean, that's a wow.
Yeah, it really is. And we're seeing more at South Shore. All of us who practice are seeing more multi-drug resistant organisms. I want to say one thing. 96 years ago, this month, Alexander Fleming accidentally discovered penicillin. Imagine the day before that. We were in a pre-antibiotic era.
Right.
What I'm trying to get at is if we continue on this course where we're seeing more and more multi-drug resistant organisms and a slowdown of antibiotic development, we could be effectively in a pre-antibiotic era.
Wow. You have been warning us about these drug resistant superbugs for a long time. You just mentioned you're seeing more at South Shore. I mean, is this something we have to be prepared for, that is going to get worse in 10, 15 years?
Absolutely. What this study showed, and this was a modeling study, they looked at the time period between 1990 and 2021, and they showed that there was a significant increase in antimicrobial resistant deaths, especially in the over 70 group. Now, one silver lining was in children under 15, especially under 5, there was a 50% reduction. But the problem is, if we continue on the track, there's going to be close to 40 million deaths attributed directly to antimicrobial resistance by 2050.
And you picked that 70 age marker. More people are living beyond 70 years old as time goes on too, right?
This is the biggest part of the population. That's right. And when people have the most comorbidities, right? So you have very sick patients as well.
Have you seen infections that don't respond to any drugs?
We have seen multi-drug resistant organisms, MRSA. We've seen an increase in what we call carbapenem resistant gram-negatives. And that carbapenem is kind of one of the last classes of defense. So once you have resistance to that, there aren't many other antibiotics you can use. And we are seeing an increase in resistance, not just at our center, but across the country and globally. Remember, this was a global study.
It almost begs the question, what's the solution?
Right. So I think some very important things. Stewardship. We can't be giving antibiotics when patients come in with a common cold. So stewardship is key. We need innovation with antibiotics. I told you that pipeline is decreasing. We have to incentivize pharmaceutical companies to develop more antibiotics. That's slowing down and that has to accelerate. And then some things that are obvious to us in the U.S. but not globally. Clean water. Hygiene, sanitation, things that a lot of this mortality that you're hearing about isn't just in the U.S., but it's in places like Southern Asia, Africa, the Caribbean. We have to have a coordinated global attack on these resistant organisms.
You've gotten our attention, Dr. T. Thank you.
Great
to see you.